Hello people, welcome back to the channel. This is part 2 of what's under the hood of your car. In this video, I will show you people what's under the hood of Hyundai i10. After watching this video, I can assure you that you will be able to identify all the parts under the hood of your car. So let's get started. So air enters from here, passes through the pipe, gets filtered and goes to the throttle body. This is the throttle body, and the cable that I am pulling right now is the accelerator cable. Pulling this opens the butterfly valve. This is the cable and socket of the throttle position sensor, or TPS as we call it. Below the TPS is the mass airflow sensor. The socket that you are seeing right now is that of the manifold absolute pressure sensor. Now fuel comes to the pipe and it gets accumulated in the silver part or a fuel rail. These are the injector sockets which send signals to the injector. There are four of them as it is four cylinder engine. The green part that you see inside is the injector. So the fuel gets accumulated in the rail and is sprayed in the cylinder through these injectors. So after the air and fuel has come inside, it will mix inside the intake manifold. The black part is the intake manifold. This is the camshaft position sensor. Located at the head, inside it will be the cam. The sensor just below the camshaft position sensor is the coolant temperature sensor. Okay, so now you would be thinking that how do I identify these sensors? Let me clear your confusion here. For identifying these sensors, I removed each of them individually and scanned my vehicle for faults and found out exactly what the fault is. Anyways, if you want to do the same or want to diagnose or fix fault in your vehicle, check out my video on how to diagnose your car by clicking the I button above or the link in the description. Coming back, to ignite the air fuel mixture, the engine needs spark. Produced by these ignition coils. Here there is two of them lighting two cylinders each. If you follow this lead, it will lead to the spark plug well. Here you can see two of the leads, the rest two leads are under the airbox. If you remove these leads, you can access the spark plugs. Okay, so let me quickly remove the entire airbox so that I can show it to you properly. So let me take a break here. This is the actual air filter inside the airbox. Now, all the four spark plug leads are visible clearly. This is the camshaft position sensor and underneath is the coolant temperature sensor. These are the two ignition coils and each have two leads. These leads go to the spark plug wells. If you remove these leads, you can see the spark plug. Now after the combustion, it is time for exhaust. These are the exhaust pipe, the silver part. Now this is a brake booster. It is mounted on the firewall. This is brake fluid reservoir, which houses the brake fluid. The marking shows the maximum and minimum level of brake fluid in the reservoir. This is a tandem master cylinder, the silver part. From the tandem master cylinder, there is high pressure line delivering brake fluid to each wheel. This part that you see inside the grill is the AC condenser. If you want to see this AC condenser clearly and other parts associated with the HVAC system of your car, you can watch my video on how to cool your car like crazy by clicking the I button above or following the link in the description. The part inside the condenser is the radiator. This is the radiator fan. This is the high pressure line of the AC system. And this is the low pressure line. And the diameter of low pressure line is greater than the diameter of high pressure line. If you follow the low pressure line, it goes to the evaporator which is inside the dashboard and cannot be seen without opening the dash. Underneath is the AC compressor, but it is not possible to show it here without lifting the car. The part I am focusing right now is the transaxle. If you don't know what transaxle is, and if you don't know about different types of drivetrains in a car, you can watch this video by clicking the I button above or following the link in the description. This is the suspension tower or the suspension mounting or the strut mounting at the top. This car has McPherson strut suspension system. If you don't know about different kinds of suspension system in a car, you can watch my video on different kinds of suspension system in the car by clicking the I button above or following the link in the description. This is the place where coolant is stored and also refilled. And this is the marking to check the coolant level. This is where the windshield washer fluid is stored. This cap is opened to fill the engine oil. This is the pressurized cap of the radiator or the cooling system. Coolant can also be filled from here, but never open it when engine is hot. This is the negative and positive terminal of the battery. Diameter of the positive terminal is greater than that of the negative terminal. This is the fuse box. Blue ones are the relays and color ones are the fuse. And here is a diagram showing the nomenclature of each fuse and relays. This is the socket for the passenger seat headlight. This one is for the driver's side. This is the alternator, which is driven by this pulley from the engine. If you want to see the parts inside an alternator and how to dismantle and assemble an alternator, you can watch this video by clicking the I button or following the link in the description. If you have to check the engine oil level and the quality of oil, this is the position of dipstick. Here you can see the marking as F and L, indicating full and low. The strut that you see right now is part of the steering rack, and the entire column is the steering rack. If I quickly remove the glove box, we can access the blower and the cabin air filter. This is the position of ECU in the car. In some car, it is under the hood. Here you can see the action of clutch as I am engaging and disengaging the clutch. This clutch cable that you see here is attached to the clutch plate in the transaxle. Now here I am pressing and releasing the accelerator pedal. You can see the action here at the throttle body. Now this is the action which happens on changing gear. Right now I am changing gears and you can see the action here. Okay, so that was too much information for a video. But I hope next time when you open the hood of your car, you can identify all the parts inside it. So let me know your thoughts on this video, and if you have any doubts, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Also, do give your suggestions and reviews. And thank you for watching and stay tuned for my upcoming videos. कुछ और चेंज करो, कोई और गियर लगाओ. बस हाँ बस बहुत.